Odell Beckham is a superstar talent. Odell Beckham deserves to be one of the highest paid receivers in all of football. I know him a little bit, see him at a lot of NBA games. We've talked on a few occasions. I genuinely like him, and I want him to get paid, and I wish him nothing but great health. But Von Miller has lost his damn mind. Let's be very, very clear. He's lost his damn mind. Do you understand that in the 16 games that Odell Beckham Jr. played last year, he only had double-digit receptions in the game 3 times? Hasn't happened this year. Now, that might not be his fault, but it does speak to how one can be neutralized playing the wide receiver position. You can get a hat put on you. That could sit up there and concuss you. You can get injured like he has. Also, it could be one of those situations where you could get double or triple teamed. Somebody has to deliver the goods because you've been somewhat neutralized to a degree. Or you can simply drop passes in cold weathers after spending a few days early in South Beach chilling with the fellas. The bottom line is this. At the wide receiver position, no matter how great you are, there's a potential to be neutralized. And when that potential exists, you can't be the highest paid player in the game, which is why you, as Darren Woodson just pointed out, you would even think about giving Aaron Rodgers more money than Odell, because Aaron Rodgers has the ability to impact the game more than Odell Beckham
Jr. Take Rodgers out of it.
Most quarterbacks. Most quarterbacks have the ability.
A, you made this argument last year, and I've come around to your way of thinking. We were arguing Le'Veon Bell or Odell. I don't know that any player other than Rodgers and maybe Brady have that much of an impact on their team's offense as Odell does.
But
the bigger point that I wanted to make is this. Von Miller's trying to change the narrative. Because what he's trying to say is that somebody other than the quarterback should be the highest paid dude. He's not fooling anybody. Yeah. I mean, we were born at night, not last night. We get what the hell he's trying to do. Look, I covered Allen Iverson, man. I covered Allen Iverson. This dude was box. It wasn't just electrifying. He was box office. But guess what? He wasn't a champion. He wasn't a champion. And no matter how great he was, there's certain limitations due to his size in terms of the kind of impact he could have. Now, that's basketball instead of football, so he still was going to get max dollars. But at the end of the day, would you have picked him over Jordan? Would you have picked him over Kobe?
No.
Would you have picked him over a few other dudes? The answer would be no.
No. Period. Anyway, so that-